And we want to get some more thoughts on this curriculum debate with this week's virtual line opinion panel. Back with us this week is line regular and former state senator Dede Feldman. We also welcome back Tom Garrity of the Garrity Group Public Relations Company. And Dave Mulryan is back in our Zoom room. He's the founder of the organization you might know of, Everybody Votes. Let's get right to the meat of what is obviously a hot button issue, guys, not just in New Mexico, but across the country. The loaded phrase of, quote, critical race theory, end quote, is bandied about on a regular basis. Simple question, Tom, is that what's happening here in New Mexico as well?
Well, it's definitely getting a lot of discussion right now. You know, obviously, this is something that, you know, the current public education secretary, Kurt Steinhaus, really wants to be able to include in the conversation. It was an initiative that was actually started about 16 months ago. And, you know, through that, we were able to, you know, see a couple of different transitions in the public education department. But these, you know, priority of updating the social study curriculum remained. And so, you know, Kurt Steinhaus runs a good shop. I think there's a lot of good conversation. What I think is always important to have in these types of situations is balance. We need to have a balanced discussion. I don't think it's a time to make up for lost time, you know, because, you know, there's a lot of, you know, really important information that needs to be updated in the social study curriculum. And I think that, you know, calmer minds need to be able to prevail. Because I could see very easily, as we've already seen, how these conversations can further divide our state and people's perceptions on public education.
Good point there. Dede, I got a question for you, kind of a straight up question. Critics contend the PED is trying to codify this CRT. Are they right?
These are regulations. These are regulations. These are not laws. So the answer is no. There is no codification here, and that it's something that the Department of Education does regularly, and it's good that it is periodically reviewed, so that it can be updated. We need to update our science curriculum, our social studies curriculum, and it's amazing how politicized this has become. It should be routine. But due to, I think, the national climate and the definite attempt by the Republican Party to demonstrate outside the PED building and to make this into another wedge issue, I think what should be routine has now become controversial.
Dave, as Dede mentioned, the state Republican Party has been leading the charge here on this, but the feedback was pretty split down the middle. Is Chairman Pierce just trying to get something going here, you know, trying to drum up the base? And
well,
if so, is he risking? Go ahead.
I mean, listen, we never know exactly what anyone's motives are, but I would also say that, you know, the idea that we need to refresh and to look at curriculum is a good point, but the bigger overriding or overarching issue here is, and we saw it in the elections in Virginia, we see it, when someone that claims to have one set of values takes a position, it automatically causes someone that has another set of values, be a Republican versus a Democrat, to take the opposite position. I mean, we instinctively have this idea, if you do this, then I must do this. And, you know, we can't all just be a black key or a white key on a piano. They work together, you know, and I think this whole idea is somehow we need to stop saying, because you believe in these things, I now believe in these. You know, not everything has to be a reaction. There are facts. There are things that we should be able to agree upon that are not just an opinion based on where you sit politically. I mean, it's absurd. It is, you know, curriculum, although I will tell you, I'm a great believer in teachers' abilities to teach what they believe to be the best thing. I mean, teachers are trained professionals. They are the king and queen of that classroom. I think they deserve our respect to do the right thing, because I think the majority of them really do. And, you know, this idea that curriculum should be top down. I agree that there should be some standards that everybody learns nationwide, yet I think that also teachers really should be the ultimate decider on what gets taught.
Hey, Tom, go ahead. Dede, you have a point there?
I just can't resist, because I used to teach history in high school long ago and far away. And the teachers do have a critical role to play, but they must be allowed to present all the facts and not omit some of the facts that have been omitted in the past. Mm-hmm. I mean, I never learned about Sojourner Truth. Mm-hmm. I never learned about Ida B. Wells or Chief Joseph or any of those people. And so I think a teacher's role here is to present the widest range of facts and opinions and teach their students how to determine what is a fact, what is an opinion,
right.
And this kind of critical and analytical thinking is what we really need in our schools mm-hmm. now. Mm-hmm. Not the knee jerk, not the balance where one side has equal weight to the other, but a critical facility.
Interesting. Tom, a little process question here. PED was only required to take public comment for 30 days. They extended that to 45 days and stayed online for last Friday's public comments until everyone was heard. You know, they were limited to 3 minutes, but everybody got heard. Is it fair? Was there enough time? Was there enough public comment in your view? Do they have enough information to make a good decision here?
Yeah, you know, I think they definitely have input. Mm-hmm. whether or not people feel like it was enough time or too much time, I think that really depends on where you stand on, not you specifically, but where the public stands on the issues being debated. Mm-hmm. Those who don't want the changes will probably say there wasn't enough public input. Those who do want changes would probably, you know, argue just the opposite. Mm-hmm. But it's in some ways, you know, I mean, it was a needed public input. I don't necessarily think that the process is one, you know, that there's input that's provided. People weigh in, and sometimes it looks as almost as if there are state agencies that will just do this to check a box mm-hmm. instead of really seeking genuine input. And you know, when you have these, you know, kind of all call, you know, everybody please state your opinions, and then everybody go in peace type stuff, it's really hard to determine if any of that is just really being absorbed and adapted mm-hmm. or if they're just really simply checking a box.
That's a fair point. Interesting question there. Hey, Dave, one of the things that Jacqueline Costales brought up in that interview is how the Yazzie-Martinez case impacts all of this. Given the courts found New Mexico is failing some of its students, shouldn't the state make sure those students' histories are in fact codified into the curriculum?
I mean, no doubt that we should codify things. And look, let's be real. The mm-hmm. world changes. You know, Dede was talking about the things that she was not taught about when she was, or that she taught when she was teaching. We, you know, the word gay was never mentioned in many of my social studies classes.
Right.
So the world does change. And I think that the argument could be made, you know, what was relevant 50 years ago has changed. If you are teaching social studies and you're taking into the modern gay rights movement and the women's movement and, you know, all of these things, I do think that they have a place. I just feel like, you know, at some point do we collectively bend to some authority that we trust because we've elected them or because we've elected people that have appointed them? Do we trust somebody, or do we have to simply second guess every single thing that we look at in terms of politics and policy? That's mm-hmm. the bigger question.
Mm-hmm. Dede, I got to remind you, of course, when we try to change the science curriculum here.
Yes, I was just going to say that.
Yes,
I was just going to say that. In 1997, 1998, when I first came into the legislature, the big thing that was happening then was there was a challenge to the teaching of science. And there were parents that came in and wanted creationism to be given equal time,
that's right,
in the name of balance mm-hmm. to evolutionary theory. And, that's what we have to beware of, because that rejects science in favor of the squeaky wheel.
Tom, pick up on it if you would. Just got a minute or so here. Squeaky wheel problem, or do we have a legit, issue that we need to just
Well, you know, I am one who supports balance.
Okay.
You know, I think that the social studies standards definitely should be updated. But as I started off, you know, I don't think it needs to go to an extreme one way or the other. You know, we need to be able to make sure that all sides and all voices are heard at the table. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Dave, I got to throw in that more than 60 teachers were in on this, involved in updating the standards.
Yes.
But other teachers said on Friday, resources, time, money, how are we going to manage all this? You know, is that a fair criticism?
Absolutely. And I think that one of the things that we should be looking at is, you know, will the second part of the infrastructure program get passed? Will there be resources for the education in this kind of thing? And how are we going to spend those resources? I mean, we are going to be having this type of discussion basically about a lot of things, because if all of this comes through, I mean, you know, one half of the bill or $1.7 trillion is going to be up for grabs. Let's not waste it. Let's use it for a good, like, for good things, you know. And if we have to, like, I don't know, I think that, again, Dee Dee's point about creationism versus the science, I think is really the relevant point here. We can't go crazy, but it seems like we always go crazy lately. You know, we lurch this way and then we lurch that way. And then everyone's like, why is everyone lurching? We need to stop lurching. You know,
if I could just very briefly add that, you know, if these updates in the social studies standards actually engage more students to get them more involved and help the proficiency standards, then I think that's a very good thing.
Good point.
Because, you know, that is the one thing that New Mexico still lacks is the really positive graduation rate. And if this helps the graduation rate by making things a little bit more relevant in the classroom, then I'm all for it.
Good place to finish. That's all the time we have for that now on that issue. But we'll be back in a few minutes to talk about the latest efforts to push back the new COVID-19 surge happening right here in New Mexico.